So what we're going to do is a practice activity that is going to be very useful in our day to day, and it's been taken out of a satsang from Guru Raj. Guru Raj had the ability to talk about certain profound subjects with lots of naturality, and he would go through them without even giving it much importance. He was elegant in the way he treated problems. And well, when you see through his satsangs, you find out that something that Guru Raj spends maybe 3 minutes, let's say 1 hour satsang, and maybe through 3 minutes he talks about something certain, and this can to an actual author to write a book about those 3 minutes. So what I write so much in the Spanish blog, or as much as the translated version for United States, I basically dedicate myself to explain these certain subjects by choosing certain quotes of Guru Raj and giving it an extension to that sentence or that idea. And maybe this will give us some kind of way of thinking of Guru Raj as the great master he was, really. Because sometimes it's kind of very dissimulated by the way he had the capability of communicating in such an easy way. It was like watching a great tennis player, say Federer or Nadal, or Pete Sampras, for example, and they make the game seem so easy that it seems easy to play. But you try to play the same way, and you can't play as good, of course. Well, if we could compare it, or we could put that down on Guru Raj, it's that capability of being able to make it look easy, which were very profound subjects indeed. So the first thing we're going to do is a meditation. We're going to do a 2-minute meditation, and I'm going to read a certain prayer, which was the favorite prayer of Guru Raj, and he commented this in certain satsangs, and I really love this satsang. We're going to meditate using the Guru Shakti picture. So Irma is going to place the Guru Shakti picture now for all of us. So as you all know, Guru Shakti is just to open up and deepen yourself into that love. Without, you don't have to start asking for things as soon as you see the photograph, but just let yourself flow through that picture. And give and take energy. Okay, so with the picture in front of us, we breathe, we relax, relax the muscles in your face. As soon as we relax the muscles in the face, our whole body relaxes. Observe the Guru Shakti picture. And when the meditation is over, I will do the Om Shanti.
Señor, hazme un instrumento de tu paz.
Lord, donde hay... make me an instrument of your peace. Déjame sembrar amor. Where there is hate, donde haya heridas, let me have love. Donde haya... where there is harm, let there be love. Esperanza. Where there is sweetly, let there be gentleness. Where there is darkness, let there be light.
Divino Maestro,
oh, concédeme, Lord, que no busque tanto, concede that I will not look so much to be consolated, but to conceal others.
El que me comprendan, como el que yo comprendo,
to be understood as to understand. Not to be loved, but as to love. For it is in giving what thy we receive. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned. And it is in dying that we are born into the eternal life. Amen.
Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Respiramos profundamente.
Breathing deeply.
Continuamos. Os continúo hablando sobre la técnica que vamos,
and
la práctica que vamos a hacer.
I'll continue talking about the practice we're gonna do today. Let's say we have some basic techniques, like we will be using the pranayamas, tratak, mantra, mandala. And then we have, I say practices instead of techniques, because they're auxiliary practices that help us just having some kind of personal equilibrium and a sensation of joy, especially in those moments that we are upset about our daily life. I like to put an emphasis in working on these practices because I miss them. In the learning that I had when I was with Guru Raj, which was excessively mystical, to say in some kind of way. And then with the years, as the years
cantidad de otras prácticas que Guru Raj
passed,
y luego pues que realmente
first the quantity of other practices that Guru Raj suggested and how useful they were. And I'm always talking about the procedure of how to assimilate these kind of teachings that we receive. If you are going to assimilate how to learn a language, there's three steps. First, there is something to learn. There is some. In that sense, Guru Raj was always opening my eyes to things that I was unknown. And I had read hundreds of books about it. Not only that, but not only read, but studied those books, communications and I had been for many years with a very narrow view of life. And Guru Raj just opened my eyes. First, you must admit, recognize there's something else. Then you have to practice what you know. If you discover golf, I'm gonna practice golf. And then the third step is to assimilate that knowledge, as you would assimilate food in the gastric system or so on. Those are the three steps: first to acknowledge, practice, and then assimilate. In within the teachings of Gururaj, Gururaj moved in three levels of experience. The first one was the practical side, things that you could practice. For example, chant was a practical technique, you know, he would give us some recommendations to do this practice. Then there's the psychological type, which is, for example, the practice of today would correspond to this kind of teaching, because it's to understand what our thoughts and where are they formed and how we can live together with them and get the most out of it. That would be the psychological part. And then there's the mystical side. The psychological side and practical side is our kind of aids for us. But when we have a great master like Gururaj, our biggest interest should be the mystical side, which I will resume in a sum up, which would be love, 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 then expressing love and being happy and joyful and happy. And the other ways in this walk are just the end paths to these final steps, which would be joy and love. For example, I'm not mystical 24 hours a day. I try to, but I don't think it's my objective, or it's not the objective that you can reach. You have to get used to doing common stuff and simple stuff, like, for example, how trying not to get involved in certain stuff and working in our psychology, for example, but knowing that they're just little aids on the way. It's not the end. For example, many people choose books that are self aid, and that ends up stopping there by just having the aid and not reaching the end. Of course, the master has to open the eyes and the mind of the student, but especially he has to open the heart. So we have the flag of love. Our flag is a heart. But while we're doing that, we have to entertain the mind. And, you know, we must be clear that we are moving between those stages of life. So depending how our day's been and the circumstances we've been in, we'll use a different technique, more psychological, more mystical, depending on the situation. The mystical can be summed up in one sentence: don't analyze darkness. Just enter the room and turn on the light. Just know when you turn off the light, darkness will come again. But just go in the room and turn on the light, which probably we'll do next Saturday, because we've been practicing getting out of the satsang of Gururaj. It's to move the spiritual energy from the supraconscious to our common conscious. And we can actually do this as many times as we want during the day. So the mystical way, we have it in our hands. Yo, we can take it anytime.
Por mi experiencia en la práctica,
but by my experience, the practice, we're not always having the right sensibility to go into the mystical side. The practice we're going to do today, it's going to solve us the problems of sadness kind, or when you're upset, little attachments in life, for example, you know, having a traffic jam crash, or having something badly said by a neighbor or a family member, or maybe just having a big expectation and not being able to achieve it. And for those kind of moments, the practice we're going to do today is quick and very interesting. It's very profound. I have to say it, I don't have control over the effect of the exterior or the things that happen in my life daily. I try to overpone them, but well, but sometimes they affect me more than I would like. It's true that sometimes I get surprised and you know, because I'm not observing what's going on, and I get that little surprise. Happened to me last week talking with my sister. So when this happens and it's an emotional pain, I could position in the Manipura, in the central chakra, where the tummy is.
It
takes me out of that expression of love, and it takes me in a stupid way out of it, and this takes away my balance. And to make it easy to visualize how I feel like if I was driving through a mountain road, very, very lonely mountain road. Maybe the youngest know the Shining by 1980s movie with Jack Nicholson, in which there's a abandoned hotel. Well, this kind of mountain, deep mountain, well, I see myself driving myself in this kind of mountain and having my car broken down. And when I park the car, I feel completely abandoned in the most extent sense. Well, let's say 1980s, there was no mobile phone. So I was without mobile phone, completely disconnected from the universe, which normally I have a good connection with. Well, sometimes this connection is broken. Well, with this practice, let's say I gain the mobile phone and I reactivate that connection very fast. The technique is, I'm just going to watch the video that Irma is going to play for us, which is a satsang from Gururaj in Canada in 1984. And I don't know why, but Gururaj never used to do this, but he wanted to show his powers. And he stops the satsang and he says, come on, start thinking in any problem you have, in any problem you have. And his voice changed, you know, when his voice changes into this tone that was like, you're gonna find out who I am, you know. When he did show off, which he did very, very, not very usually, so in the last years he did it more often. In the last year he was in Spain, he did it the whole week. The whole week he showed off how much he could go. But here he does it as well. And I'm gonna meditate. You close your eyes and meditate. And what he proposes basically, when he you want to solve a problem, when you meditate and you're in a place of stillness and the conversation inside your mind is more silenced, and when that is happening, as the problem was very, very close to the superficial side of the mind, when we meditate and we go to a deeper side of our mind, from that perspective, the problem seems insignificant. And the solution appears by itself. I've been practicing this for years, and it never stops working. Well, we can do comments on this later, etc. Which doesn't need us to be very honest and sincere. The most important preamble before we do this is we consider that some of the guilt must be in our side. Even though we have many reasons in our side from who has the responsibility on this, we are never 100% right. So we're gonna play the video, the satsang of Guru Raj, and when it's over, I will comment how we're gonna do this practice. Okay, Irma.
It's just a pretty anywhere time to study more. Actually, Chetanji is going to teach me Spanish one day. I could sit here now. And not say a word. Think of any problem you have in your mind. Come on. Think of any problem you have in your mind. Now. Close your eyes if you want to. Keep them open if you want to. It's entirely up to you. Think of any problem you have in your mind. Any problem you have in your mind. And within 5 minutes, you will find the solution within yourself. In 5 minutes. Think of the problem for 1 or 2 minutes and just be quiet. And I shall go into meditation. Have you thought of any problem you had in mind? Has it been resolved? Put up your hands, put them down beside. Have exercises. Quite a number. Yeah. Now, when you start meditating and become a meditator, you will find that you just need to sit down for 1 minute, mull over the problem, and the answer will dawn. And the reason is so simple. It's so simple that it sounds ridiculous. That the problem that you are going through is on the small surface conscious level of the mind. Now, when you meditate and do your spiritual practices, you're diving deeper within yourself. And that depth that is there within yourself brings forth the solution to the problem. You understand me, sister? You should. God bless for joining us this lovely night.
Vale, pues hasta aquí es, Irma.
So it's up to here. I'm gonna just comment a few things. He meditates in the video, but it's been cut off. But something curious and very, very intriguing. I don't know if you realize how at the surroundings of the eyes, they will become completely black. You would see sometimes how he would change his physical appearance. Sometimes he would be very white, sometimes he'd be very dark, and I always say that it was based on his energy, and it would be very visible. And if you see the video, you can't see why he gave that turn. He probably perceived some kind of very strong thought between the assistants. And you know, when you're watching, you know, we go through the magic sense or the miracle, because he's been meditating. He has a lot of spiritual energy, and he solves my problems. But we have to let go that kind of path, because it's a natural law that is subtle. Gravity, until it was written by Newton, it was a subtle natural law. So these laws have always existed, but sometimes a human being writes it down in a paper, and we appreciate it as a scientific law. And he explains this. And there is nothing magical or miraculous about it. One of the things that Guraj has that is so great is that any miracle that occurs, he explains. And he explains in all detail. Maybe you have to see the satsang in a slow motion to understand. So I understand it can be complex, but he does give us all of the information step by step. So maybe if you watch the satsang that says 20 times, that he advised to watch 20 times to understand. He says in a kind of complaining way, all theologies tell you know thyself, but they do not tell you how thou must one know himself. They don't give you the steps. They don't give you anything. And he gives you the steps one by one. And it's something that we have to look in. And not only he explains with the mind and verbalizing, but also he gave us that energy, that Shakti, so we could get through to those messages. For me, it's very easy to get through this message. I'm a person who doesn't believe in concepts. So nothing that I tell you is mine. I don't oppose any of the ideas of Guru Raj. They all have been correct, and any time that I've put them into practice, they've worked. Always, always. It's 40 years. And I have been a financial director of businesses. I'm not a monk in a monastery. My nature is ego and business and fighting. You know, I don't know why. It's not that I'm proud of it. It's just that my energy was light in those situations. And Guru Raj gave us that umbrella to cover us. Not only he gave us the practices, but also he gave us that energy. And I don't know if many teachers of Harvard also can give all of these teachings and give the energy. Sometimes we don't value the energy we receive, not just the teaching. In my opinion, to be happy, to all of the ones that are we're here, to be happy is to not to stop laughing all day. And it's easy. Anyone who has listened and practiced the teachings of Guru Raj through sometimes, let's say 1-2 years, then it's easy. Everything is there. It's like Mary Poppins' handbag, you know, once you open it, you have everything there. And if we don't find it, we just blame him for it. When I'm talking in these speeches, I blame him. I don't like giving these chats. So I just blame him. You know what you're doing. Okay, so we're gonna do exactly that technique here. It's not an importance of magic, and it's something that we understand. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna do 3 rounds of Aim Him Cream chant, and this will create that stillness in the mind. And as soon as we finish the 3 rounds, each one individually is gonna meditate. We will all do our individual mantra, or if you're doing preparatory mantra, but I think we all have individual mantras here. And just for 2-4 minutes, we're gonna place our mind in a certain problem. It's quite interesting, because when I was young and I met Guru Raj, I didn't have many problems. Then I had many, but you know, now I have them. And this is how I solve them. And this is the way. And I've been 2 years writing regularly every day about the Guru Raj, about the teachings of Guru Raj. And it all comes about because when I meditate, the text come out by themselves after. Sometimes it's even uncomfortable because I meditate and I just wanted to meditate, but once I finish, it seems I have to write down something from this point of view. Okay, so let's do the three rounds, and we're going to give ourselves 4 minutes to think on some problem and bring our attention to that problem and to listen how to solve that. And we listen quietly, and it comes in a silence way, or it comes in a sentence, or it guides you in a way, but it gives you a way to think, this is the way I should start. Then we just do our individual mantra until we've done around 20 minutes. And then I will read a prayer, favorite prayer of Guru Raj. And we will do the Om Shanti. So we'll do it very relaxed way. And once we're in a place of stillness, we meditate a little bit. Go to our most deepest side. We take the attention of the mind to that certain problem and wait in silence for that response while we do our individual mantra. The prayer for Jiru is translated in English. I don't know if Irma has sent it to you or not. Is the prayer of sweetness. If not, Irma, can you send him the translation?
See, I did send the translation.
He's Fernando. Already got it, don't worry.
Bueno, pues respiramos profundamente, cerramos los ojos.
Breathe deeply. Join the hands, feet touching, relax our face and muscles, breathing deeply, relax our face muscles, and let's enjoy. We're really gonna enjoy this.
Primera ronda, Aim Ring Kring Chamundaye Vicheche, 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 Aim Ring Kring Chamundaye Vicheche. 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 Embring Queen Chamunda Yevi Cheche. 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 Embring Queen Chamunda Yevi Cheche.
Segunda ronda. Aimring Krin Chamundaye Vicheche. 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 Em rin kin chamunda ye vi che che. 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 Em rin krim chamunda ye vi che che. Tercera ronda. Em rin krin chamunda ye vi che che. 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 Emrin Kirin Chamundaye Vicheche, 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 Emrin Kirin Chamundaye Vicheche. Oración de la dulzura. Pueda el viento soplar con dulzura.
May the wind blow gently and the rivers flow sweetly. May the plants and herbs be sweet with us.
Ser dulces con nosotros.
Y que los días and may the days and nights give us their sweetness.
Pueda el cielo que nos protege.
May the heaven that protects us guide us sweetly.
Y que los árboles
and may the trees be sweet to us. May the sun shine upon us sweetly. And may we be able to procure our food with gentleness. May we ever be united in the sweet embrace of your love. May all beings find their happiness. That all beings may live in peace. May your blessing be with all beings.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Hacemos una respiración profunda.
Take a deep breath. And bring our breath to normality.
Y poco a poco vamos
and gently
los ojos.
And slowly open our eyes.
Thank you, gracias.
Gracias.
Gracias, Fernando.
No, gracias a vosotros.
Thank you all.
Thank you, Javier.
Muchas gracias, Fernando.
Thank you, Fernando.
Gracias a ti, Mónica.
Thank you, Fernando. Beautiful.
Muchas gracias, Fernando.
Oh, Mary, oh, Dorina, estuvisteis en el Sasan.
Mary and Dorina, were you in the satsang of the 20 times? Were you present at the time?
Yes, I was. Uh-huh. I was in that one. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's very profound. I have listened to it 20 or 40 times by now, maybe. Yeah.
I did not meet Gurush. I started meditating in 1989.
I
did not meet him in the physical.
I see.
Fernando, sí. Recordarme en Pennsylvania, en la El Coso, en Pennsylvania, muchos años. The International Force.
Sí, yes, I remember. Yeah. Which one?
Wait, I can't hear.
Yeah.
No, I can't hear.
Yiru, ¿está, alguien está traduciendo?
Yeah, I'm translating. But I can't translate from English to Spanish.
She can speak Spanish, so just Fernando.
I can. Yo puedo hablar poquito, sí.
Okay, I can. And, I can speak. Irma can speak perfectly.
And Irma or Jito, I just wanted to ask him if he remembers me from the 1980s course, sometime in the 80s in Pennsylvania.
Que si lo recuerdas, oh, he can understand.
Can't hear.
Change your translation.
I think he's changed a lot physically.
Oh, yo también.
We're very young, so.
Yo también, yeah, muchos años pasado.
I can't really remember your physically, how you were at that time. But definitely we enjoyed a lot those times.
Mi pelo es como Irma.
My cousin is like Irma.
Tu cabello, your hair was as long as mine. Dice que su cabello estaba igual de largo como el mío.
Yeah, and yo tengo dos hijos muy chiquitos.
Two sons. A big kiss to your sons. It was a surprise.
Tell him, Suje y yo son ambasadores con los ellos que están allá en de Spain. Muchas personas de Spain.
Sí. Sí. Creo que sí entendiste.
And estamos drinking, which is alcohol. I remember.
You have been in Spain in one of the. You have been in Spain in a course.
Yo quiero un tiempo, pero no.
No, I wanted, but I never.
Yeah. I have been to a Spanish course.
We were very similar in character, the American meditators with the Spanish meditators. We were similar, maybe with the British or the Danish. We were much more similar with, or I feel more similar to the American Society meditation. It surprised me.
Yeah.
It happens to us with the Italian people. Spanish and Italian people are different, but we're very similar in many ways. And the sense of humor, like how you approach, was very similar.
Yeah, I got engaged with you.
So now I'm in contact with you.
Nice, very nice.
Is that Ramon's shadow we're seeing?
Yeah.
Is that Ramon's shadow we can see?
The ghost of Ramon. I don't know.
Okay, well.
Like this, because I am in an old computer and I don't know.
I'm in an old. Next Saturday, we will make a practice related to mysticism. Also coming from Satsang from Guruji. It's a very powerful tool, and it's very easy to use.
Pero Fernando, si hablas en español, en inglés,
if you talk in English,
no te entienden,
the Spanish will not understand because Jiru has to translate in English. Well, but I don't know if he's translating or not. He's translating.
Sí.
Who's translating?
Está traduciendo.
He's translating. I am translating. Oh, because Dorina was speaking to me in Spanish.
Oh.
And then okay. Okay. I next Saturday we're gonna do this practice. We all mostly know it, we've done it many times, but it's very potent, which is to trespass the from the superconscious to the conscious mind, and we can do it as many times as we want in a day. And Guru Raj commented through 2 minutes in a satsang, maybe he talks 3,000 hours that he's been recorded, but every 2 minutes he will give us more or less an advice and a practice to do that will guide us to happiness. We could say as disciples we were very clumsy, and I'm including myself, because in the years that this was happening, I was not able to read all of the things that he talked about. You know, I got many things without talking all the things you can learn through silence. And now that I have to express, it's more difficult. But if we go to the recorded satsangs of Guru Raj, it's incredible. He describes step by step how to do it. Things that people normally would consider miracles. But if somebody describes how they did a miracle, it stops being a miracle and it just becomes a natural law. And this is it continues. I've never found anything similar. Even there are many doctors, Hindu doctors that are very famous, talking about meditation and... No, we've stayed in that comfort. Because, but we need to reach more people. I don't understand how we don't reach more people. Well, yeah, I do understand. The times are marked by Guruji, but the material we have recorded by the master we had, I just don't understand it. This morning I send you all a writing where Jesus says to these disciples, I cannot call you my workers, my servants, because the servant does not know what the owner really is doing. And to you I have told you everything I know. Everything I know of my father I've told you. So that's why you are my friends. And I feel as a friend of Guru Raj. And as he was said in that satsang 20 times, okay, let's see if we can speed it up a bit. I'm already in it. Anything that stops me from being happy, atom bomb. This one that we've done today resolves lots of small things in the day today, with family members, with the boss. And whatever comes next Saturday, life will solve it for us. If we listen to 2 minutes but clearly of Guru Raj, of the mystical side, but you know, before you become mystical, first you have to be engineer, then you have to become president, and then you become mystical. In 2 minutes, he usually solves it. So, I hope that we can make it together, those 2 minutes, and making it fun. So, thank you all for coming. Big kiss. to everyone and see you soon. Dorina, Mary.